Okay, and another thing I need to add, when I was talking about in the first video, previous video, we need to round this off right here, round it off in the back, so it's not digging into our skin, so it's comfortable like an electric guitar strap. And I realized too that these things are squared off right here so they can put binding. Well, all we got to do is just, you know, round it off, make the wood match, round it off, curve it together, and you can still put the binding in. The binding will just come into the body like that. And that way you can still, and you can, this binding right here, all you'd have to do is just flatten the binding out. So square it off here and then just flatten it out as it gets on the body, and it's going to be a nice smooth round, flat it out, and then square it back off when it gets right there. You know, to me, who cares what it looks like if it looks like it's, you know, you got this binding going right in the middle of the body. To me, it's like, who cares? Who cares what it looks like? Comfort's more important than what it looks like. And besides, everything I've noticed in life for me, everything to me, I get real picky when I first get it and I look at it, or if I set something up, or I fix a wall, or I hang a picture and everything. Everything's always picky at the first moment when you finish the work. You know, everything's picky, you're sitting there, oh, it's just a little bit crooked, oh, it's the 16th off now. Everything's all perfect, you know. But when you go and you forget about it, you go throughout your day, you sit down, a week goes by, a month goes by, you forget all about it. You forget all about how it looks, whether, you know, it's all, if it's off or not. You get a stain in your carpet, and you're like, oh, at first, like, oh, it's terrible, terrible, looks terrible, terrible. But as the days go by, you start to forget all about that stain that's on the carpet, man. Or at least I do. I start to forget all about that stain. A scratch on the car, the dent on the car, I start to forget all about it. My senses just gets used to it, and it's just there now. It's kind of like a scar on the arm. You get cut, you get a scar on the arm, man. I get used to having a scar on the arm. I don't even think about it no more. You know, I'm comfortable with it, so that's the point. I'm sitting here, I'm about 5 or 6 foot away from the computer speaker. Now I'm going to sit down. There we are. Now I'm about, probably about 6-7 foot away now. So here we are, just chilling out now, chillaxing. Pardon me! Also, we need to, I like to have a scallop neck on this acoustic. And also get some of them Edward Van Halen stainless steel frets that don't wear out. So I can sit here and, sitting here spinning these frets up on the 21st fret. Let's see. 15, 17, 19. On the 20th fret. I can feel it digging into the frets, man. this thing's got acoustic guitar strings on it, but eventually when they all break, I'm going to start replacing them with electric guitar strings. The same gauge that's on my acoustic guitar, or my electric guitar. And, you know, this is good for building up strength and everything, and you know, I get a better sound out of it, but, you know, I think I'll be able to live with acoustic or electric guitar strings on this acoustic. Besides, you know, like I said, at first, you know, just like anything else, apply the logic of first view or first sound, like I was talking about in the beginning of the video. At first, you know, my ear is going to be like, it doesn't sound good, but I'll just get used to it, and it'll be comfortable to play, man. Lighter gauge strings. About having an acoustic is sometimes I don't feel like turning on my amp, you know. I just want to pick the guitar up and start playing right now. You know, I do that with my electric a lot. I'll just pick it up, you know, just start playing it without even turning on the amp, plugging it in or anything like that. And I have a good old time on it, and it sounds cool too. So that's the advantage for me for having an acoustic. I can just pick this thing up and it's a lot louder sounding than my electric. Building up blisters on the fingers anyway, and for strength. Then when I get on the electric, you know, I'll be a little more stronger. Now, I thought that was a great idea, man. Take this hole, back this hole up, so it's down there where the picking hand's at, you know, resting on the bridge. When I ain't got my hand on the bridge and I'm just strumming, because of where my hand is right here, where my arm rests, naturally just rests right there, I'm not even strumming right over the hole. I'd have to go uncomfortable and bring my arm up a little bit to actually strum over the hole, then I gotta force myself to keep my arm there. I just wanted to be relaxed and everything right here, so I think taking this hole, move the hole back, and put 22 frets on these things, and then cut this body out a little bit better. Shade the stuff on the back, form it out in the back, so we can get up here and hit these high frets like an electric. Because when I'm playing guitar, man, I like to hit all the notes.